ना मुझे घर नहीं, इनको विचारों की है जड़ वे। ये जो चमकी तारे में पे पूरी रात प्रकृति साथ वो जो गरीब पास नहीं हम गरीब पास में फिर भी चिंचारी ए। अतीत की चादर ओढ़े खोया आज उन गुफाओं में है चंदा जाके पीछे चिपटा रात। इन पहाड़ों के चमकता जुगनू जैसे तारे लाल इन फिजाओं में लपक के बांधा मैंने फीता छाप छोड़े चला। मुझे किस किस ने क्या क्या कहा भटकता रहा मैं सिर्फ आवारा। मैं एक बादल में चलता रहा गगन बरस पड़ा तो आवा
is the intriguing study of handwriting and signature, which is used to infer a person's thoughts and character. Soljak helps people transform their lives by rewiring and working on their subconscious mind. Ms. Sahiba, the founder of Soljak, is an exemplary leader and motivator. With an unwavering passion to help humankind. We are extremely honored and delighted to have her on board with us, and we can't wait for all the exciting and enthralling activities coming ahead. Welcome back, ma'am. How are
you? Thank you. Thank you so much. So, how are you all?
I'm doing
I can't hear anyone. How are you all?
Right, come on.
We are fine, ma'am.
Great. Meeting by college, expecting some more noise.
I think we have enabled the option wherein the attendees can't.
Okay, chalo. Let's start then. So, thank you so much. And Kainat, are you there?
I'm there.
So, can we start with the slide?
Yeah. Before we start, I would just like to introduce Mithibai Kshitij to you. Would that be okay?
Sure.
Yeah. So, Mithibai Kshitij are the organizers for today's event. And Kshitij is the annual International Intercollegiate Cultural Festival of Mithibai College. And it has been prospering since 2007 with a working committee of 700 students organizing musical concerts such as Salim Suleiman, Vishal Shekhar, Mohit Chauhan, Farhan Akhtar, and 50 plus events each year. Kshitij has also introduced the first ever Swachhathon, which is the Green Run. It is basically a 7 kilometer long marathon. This year, due to unforeseen circumstances, Kshitij is being held online. And even then, they are connecting a grand working committee via video conferencing. It is a platform for college students from all over the country to portray their talents. And Kshitij has organized various online activities so far during the pandemic with a set list of major personalities. This is just a glimpse of what is to come as Mithibai Kshitij is working diligently towards creating a beautiful experience for everybody. Once again, thank you, ma'am, for joining us. We can
thank you. Thank you so much. And it's an honor to be over here. So thank you. So let's start, and thank you everyone. Thank you for joining in. And next slide. Thank you for taking out time for, to know about graphology. So before we log in, before we begin the session, I would like you to log into my website, that is www.soljak.com, and it's we are also available on Facebook on in the name of Soljak by Sahiba Aivasudev, and on Instagram we are by the name of Soljak by Sahiba, and you can log in over there simultaneously. And next slide. So before we begin, let me give you a glimpse about Who am I? So I'm a graphologist by profession. I'm a clinical hypnotherapist, parenting expert, behavioral therapist, and a psychology teacher. So my basically, I started as a psychology teacher, and then the journey, you know, started of exploring how the subconscious mind works. And my journey till now has been a wonderful journey. And it's been such a, you know, wonderful experience to learn how and how the subconscious mind really works. So next slide. So before we begin, what is graphology? Graphology hoti kya hai? So graphology is the study of handwriting analysis. Graphology is the study of graphic movement. Just as two people do not have the same DNA, exactly the same way two people cannot have same handwriting. Graphic means writing, ology means science or study. Graphology is the science of knowing human thought process. So it's, you know, very, if you've seen the era where, you know, maybe your parents, I would say, there was an era where, you know, we used to write letters and envelope dekhte saath we used to say, oh, you know, this is my cousin's hand, cousin's letter, but just because looking at the handwriting, we used to say it. So how did we recognize that, you know, my so-and-so cousin has written letter to me? It is only through handwriting. So handwriting is the, from the handwriting, we can come to know so much about personal life, their professional life, so many things. So a lot of people do ask me, graphology is for whom? So they feel that, you know, graphology is only for parents, or graphology is only for psychology students. So there is n number of lists. So graphology is for there's a one more slide before that. So graphology is for parents, graphology is for MBA experts, graphology is for HR professionals, graphology is very useful for marketing professionals, life coach, counselors, trainers, psychologists, people studying psychology, next slide, marriage compatibility, employers for personal selection, psychologists, individual for self-improvement, law enforcement, and anyone and everyone who wants to learn about personality, about different people's personality. So it is for anyone and everyone who wants to learn about personality. Next slide. So graphology is based on three things. One is geometry, one is physics, and one is human anatomy. Now, why geometry? If you've seen in geometry, there's a tool called D, protector, just like it there. So what is D? D mein hum angles dekhte hain. Like, you know, from 0 to 90, 90 to 80. These angles tell us in handwriting, there are slants. If the person's handwriting, like if your handwriting is going like this, there is a slant. If the slant is towards, you know, towards your right side, towards this side, that means the person is, if the handwriting is towards your right side, so the person is more emotional. If the handwriting is vertical, the person is logical. And if the handwriting of the slant is going towards the left side, the person is, you know, his head, I would say his head works more rather than the heart. He is hardcore logical mind. So why physics? If you've seen, what is physics? What were the topics that we used to study in physics? That were speed, force. This is what we have studied in physics. These all things are very important in graphology also. So if I say pressure, so people who are having, you know, heavy pressure handwriting, like if I write like this, this is a heavy pressure. So people who write with heavy pressure, what are they doing? They are somewhere putting lot of force. So there is a lot of mental force in that. them. There is a lot of mental energy which needs to be released. So people with heavy, heavy pressure, they write, they have a lot of mental energy. So people who write with light pressure, so that is, they are somewhere, they are not that strong, or they are not mentally, they don't have that much of, intensity as heavy pressure people have. So when we talk about human anatomy, we are at the end of the day, what are we doing? We are at the end of the day, we are talking about humans. We are talking about human mind. So human anatomy is also based on graphology. Kainat, next. So what are the aspects? Kya kya cheeze hum pad sakte hain? Kya kya cheeze hum samajh sakte hain graphology ke through? Hum health mein dekh sakte hain. Your BP, your cholesterol, a lot of health issues can be analyzed through a graphology. Your personality. Personality mein there are n number of traits that we can come to know through graphology. Relationship compatibility, if two people are having, the same mindset or the same mental energy, obviously the compatibility becomes more easy. And if we talk about wealth, so this is quite interesting. Now, you tell me, what is the difference between this, difference between this, and difference between this? Now, both three of them are Y. But here, the bag of trust is complete. Here, the bag of trust is, it's almost there and still not complete. And here, it has not even reached halfway. So, that from Y, we can also come to know about the concept of money. And through this, we can also analyze how much do you trust people around you for finances? And how much is your subconsciously, how do you, value money? So this also is one of the aspects through which we can come to know up. This is also one of the aspects we can analyze through graphology. Next. So limitations of graphology. What is there that we cannot or we cannot analyze? One is sex determination. So people do ask why sex determination cannot be analyzed. So have you ever heard of yin and yang energies? Every female has a masculine energy and a female energy, and every a male is going to have a female and a masculine energy. So it's both yin and yang energies together. So we cannot come to know, because a female can be as dominating as a man, and a man can be as soft as a female. So sex determination, it becomes little difficult when we, there is a limitation of graphology in terms of sex determination. Age determination, we cannot determine whether the person is 14 year or a 40 year old person. Why? Because it is, 0 to 7 years. 0 to 7 years is the time when a person's mother, you are influenced by your mother. And 7 to 40 is the time when you are influenced by your father. So somewhere down the line, your mother tells you about warmth, love, affection. And 7 to 14 is the time when your father tells you about jisko hum bolte hain duniyadari. So from inward feeling to the outward feeling, aap inward, 0 to 7 mein aap inward ho, you're learning affection, love, trust. And 7 to 14 mein aapko samajh mein aata hai ki aapko duniya ko kaise face karna. You know how to, this is my school teacher, I need to behave properly. Oh, this is my friend, I need to share things with him. So, duniyadari ek father samjhata hai. So, ये सारे एक्सपीरियंसेस 0 to 7 एंड 7 to 14 की जो एक्सपीरियंसेस हैं, ये आपकी एक पर्सनालिटी बनाते हैं. सो मेरे जो एक्सपीरियंसेस हैं वो किसी और के साथ मैच नहीं कर पाएंगे. सो एज डिटर्मिनेशन इज 14-year-old child can also be as mature as a 40-year-old person. And a 40-year-old person can also be immature as a 14-year-old person. So in this, because of the experiences that you have gone through from 0 to 14 years, you know, that has an effect that it becomes difficult for us to determine the age. The person is right hand or left hand. So it is very, very interesting to know that we generally say that yaar main to haath se likh raha. Hands are mere instrument. It is the brain which is the source. So pen is the tongue of the subconscious mind. So brain or the subconscious mind, jo hai, wo, the brain is the one which is transmitting the message to the nervous system. And from there, it is being transmitted to the hands. And hands are just instruments. So what about people who are not blessed with hands? Have you ever seen some people who are not blessed with hands? They are writing with their legs, right? How are they doing it? Because again, hands are just mere instruments. It is the brain. The source is coming from the brain. The experiences are coming from the brain, the subconscious mind. So the person is right hand or left hand, it becomes really difficult. Nationality, caste, creed, religion, we cannot determine. Now this is next is fortune telling. Lot of people have this a misconception that, you know, because through graphology, we can tell fortune telling. Arre, meri handwriting dekh ke batana yaar, mera agle 5 saal mein paisa aayega ki nahi aayega. So it is interesting that astrologers, numerologists, tarot card readers, they do study graphology just to make their analysis even more perfect. But through graphology, we cannot do fortune telling. So the tarot card reader, astrologers, numerologists, yes, they do study graphology just to enhance their prediction so that they are more accurate about the personality, but not the fortune telling. Okay. So next slide. So now let's study how do we analyze about people. Okay. So aggressive nature. Ab hame kaise pata chalega ki ek insaan aggressive hai ki nahi hai. Now, if the lower loops of the letter like Y, G, F, if you look here, it is rigid lines. These are rigid. Rigid. You know, it's going like this. So if the lower loops of the letter like Y, J, F, etc. show a rigid, hard upstrokes going towards the right, it's going towards right. It reveals an aggressive and forceful person. I am so rigid and forceful that I'm putting my pen here and then moving it here. Here. It is showing my aggression. Such writer has a strong need of physically aggressive outlets. Like I need to be physically so aggressive to release my energy. And they can be in the field of sports or they can even be more violent, I would say. Energy release kaise karenge wo? You know, sports ke through karenge, gymming karenge ya violence ke through karenge. Okay, next slide. Ambition. If a person is ambitious or not. So this is T stem and this is T bar crossing. So an ambitious personality can be determined by high T bar in writing. High T bar indicates higher goals. If your T bar is low, such people are not ambitious. These are those people who are ambitious about their goals. Next. Kainat, next. Kainat? Yeah. Argumentative nature. The easiest way to identify argumentative nature is by looking at the small case letter P. Now, if you see, P has this opening. What are you doing? Opening a path. आओ भैया चलो आकर लड़ाई करते हैं थोड़ी सी बहस करते हैं ठीक है. So the easiest way to identify argumentative nature is by looking at the small case letter P. If the formation of P is showing a break away stroke like letter V, V is for what? Violence, right? So here it is becoming a V. This is becoming V. It is suggestive of argumentative nature. The degree of the tendency depends upon the frequency of such P's in the whole script. Agar aapke whole A4 sheet, ek to sabse pehle we write on the A4 sheet to analyze the handwriting. We don't take it on the ruled paper. We take it on the unruled paper, that is the A4 sheet. So A4 sheet per when you write the whole paper. So the number of P's you have written, we will count it. And if they are about 80% of the P's are like this, then you can see say that the person is highly argumentative. But if the P is, these are coming to 30 to 40% of the P's are like this, then you can say that the you know they are comparatively less argumentative than the other people. Next slide. Okay, now, desire for attention. I am looking for attention. मुझे तो भैया जिस पार्टी में भी जाना है ना अटेंशन चाहिए. बस लोग मुझे देखें और मेरे बारे में ही बात करें. अब ऐसे लोगों को कैसे हम जज कर सकते हैं या कैसे हम देख सकते हैं या पता कर सकते हैं कि इस बंदे में ये ज्यादा पर्सनैलिटी ट्रेट ज्यादा प्रोमिनेंट है. सो इफ यू सी this, you know, extending a hand type, extended ending strokes. Now, what is ending strokes? This is ending stroke and this is beginning stroke. So, I am talking about ending stroke. So, extended ending strokes reveal a keen desire to catch others' attention. The writer is exhibitionist and wants to be the center of attention. Mujhe to chahiye attention, chahe main kisi bhi way mein attention seek karu. Now this can be in the form of, you can say that I dress up nicely or I be very, very nice to everybody, but I want attention in any form. His need for approval and recognition is quite high. Hence, in social gatherings, such writers try to catch others' attention towards him. Okay, next is how do we come to know that the person is enthusiastic, has a lot of excitement or is enthusiast? By looking at the letter T. So this, the T bar becomes long. First, in the first PPT where we spoke about the letter T, we talked about the goals that were if it is high, but right now we are talking about high as well as we are talking about long. So if it is high, then we are saying it is ambitious. But here, if it is long, then we are saying that long horizontal strokes, particularly the T bars, reveal excitement and enthusiasm. This writer is motivated easily. Enthusiasm is an important factor for success. Okay, there's one more thing that I would like to share. Now, So now, what is the difference between both? Both of them are the same letters. Here, the T I have written first, T, and then done the crossbar. Secondly, again T, and then the crossbar. In the second one, the crossbar is same. So this person can handle a lot of projects together at the same time. This person will first finish the project A, then move on to the project B. Okay? So this also we can come to know from letter T. Next, fear of success. Now, when I told you about wealth, when we were talking about wealth in the topic aspects, I did mention that, you know, why through Y or G, you know, through Y, you can, this is the bag of trust, if we spoke about it. Ab, it becomes like your bag of trust is there, the person has achieved, and yet he moved downward. So, such people have fear of success. They will achieve and ho sakta hai achieve ke baad inko dar lage ki main yahan par maintain nahi kar paungi. Main yahan maintain nahi kar paungi success ko and they go downward. So fear of success is more or is there a lot in such people. If the lower loop of letter like G, Y, Z, etc. look downturns instead of reaching the baseline, it is suggestive of fear of success. This is a feeling of dejection. The writer reaches near his destination, that is the baseline. Baseline is from where you have started. But suddenly gets a U-turn, a negative trait. So U-turn achanak se is bande ne success lete lete U-turn le liya. Next slide. Now low self-esteem. So as we have already mentioned in the letter T, so this person is jiska low self-esteem bahut hoga because T bar niche hai, so low self-esteem hoga. It is also very interesting to know, yes, it is a negative trait. Definitely it's a negative trait that such people have low self-esteem. But if you are targeting at, you know, selling a product, if you are targeting for, this is for marketing people who wants to go into marketing tomorrow, people who have low self-esteem, they are your first clients. Aap sabse pehle product inhi ko bechoge kyunki thoda sa bhi inko importance diya gaya. या थोड़ा सा भी इनका रेस किया गया कि ओ मैम यू लुकिंग वेरी नाइस, ओ मैम दिस विल लुक रियली नाइस ऑन यू, सो इनका स्टीम थोड़ा सा हाई हो जाएगा इन टर्म्स ऑफ दे विल बी फील दे फील दे विल फील दैट यू नो यस आई एम गेटिंग इम्पोर्टेंस और यू नो और दिस माइट बी अ प्रोडक्ट जिसमें मुझे थोड़ा सा अच्छा लगे. सो दिस कैन बी फॉर मार्केटिंग पीपल, इट कैन बी यू नो यू कैन लुक एट देम टू सेल देयर प्रोडक्ट वेरी इजीली. नाउ लाइंग टेंडेंसी. फ्रॉम लेटर ओ वी कम टू नो अबाउट लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स. नाउ दिस ओ इज लाइक योर स्टमक, पेट को अच्छे से बांध के रखा हुआ है, ठीक है. These people will not share your secrets anywhere. But if it is open, they will sari ki sari baatein bahar niklengi. So if any of your friend whose O is open, don't share your secrets. And if a person writes like this, there is a loop and it is open also. And if you are writing there like this, I have seen so many people who write O like this. Look at the double loop in the letter O, also in the letter A also, sometimes in A also. Such loops within the circle reveal a lying tendency. Such people have a habit of lying also. Be it for selfish motive or simply in an easygoing way. अरे यार मैं तो ऐसे ही बोल देता हूँ हंसी मजाक में. The writer has ultimately the writer has a tendency to lie. Next, organizational skills. Now, organizational skills को हम letter F से पता कर सकते हैं. Okay. Now, if I divide the alphabet or letter F into two parts, this part helps in telling us about planning. And this part tells about execution. Now, if a person writes, if a person writes only like this, so planning hai, execution missing hai. ठीक है. अब अगर एक बंदा ऐसे लिखता है, इसमें एग्जीक्यूशन है, प्लानिंग मिसिंग है, राइट? सो द बेस्ट वे इज टू राइट इन दिस मैनर. बट नाउ द क्वेश्चन कम्स, इफ यू आर अ मैनेजर और यू आर in a position where your employee has a planning and you also have a planning, is your planning is strong and even his planning is strong, somewhere down the person, that person has the capability to become your competitor. So you can, I'm not saying you should, but you can go for people who are under you, who have more of execution pass, whose F is like this, they will follow you like anything. जो भी बॉस ने कहा ये फॉलो करेंगे, क्योंकि दिमाग से तो वो काम कर ही नहीं रहे ना, वो तो बॉस की कही भी बात को एग्जीक्यूट कर रहे हैं, right? But if you are on a higher position, then and if you ask me an accurate F, then it is planning and execution both. Okay. So procrastination. Now, please understand that left is towards past and right is towards future, right? Now what happens is, people who tend to write like this, what are they doing? Past में रह रहे हैं, कोई project आया, let's say tomorrow Mithi Bhai College में आपको कोई project देना है by 12 o'clock, okay? So there are chances this person will sit at 11th hour and say, अरे यार कल करने तो बैठ रहा हूँ यार, वो मैम ने ना कल graphology की एक workshop कराई थी, अरे यार उसमें ना ये करा था यार, वर्कशॉप थी तो ठीक, योर वर्क इज टू डू द प्रोजेक्ट राइट नाउ एंड यू आर थिंकिंग अबाउट द पास्ट, सो द पास्ट थॉट्स आर कमिंग एज एन हिंड्रेंस टू मूव अहेड इन लाइफ. सो दिस पर्सन इज नॉट कमिंग टू द प्रेजेंट एंड नॉट मूविंग अहेड. सो प्रोक्रास्टिनेशन डेफिनेटली हैपेंस ऑटोमेटिकली, डिले ऑफ वर्क shown by the T-bar which are crossed on the left side of the vertical stem, this is a sign of negligence or hesitation. Such writer has a tendency to postpone decision instead of facing the current problem. Abhi tak se to theek hai, till the time you are in school or colleges, but tomorrow when you go in offices or your workplace, people who tend to write as T like this, or not completing their T, or not completing, or have a habit of procrastination, it becomes a major problem for you to fulfill your official work. So complete your T's. It's very, very important, and raise them. T bar should be raised. Now, this is Personally, this is one of my favorite because Felon's Claw. So how do I come to know whether the person I'm trusting is a cheater or not? I don't know whether the person is a cheater or not. So people who write like this, basically it's a claw. You know, pakda hua hai kisi ne. Jaise ek pakda hua hai. So it's like a formation of a claw. So such people are sweet talkers. They will be, you know, they will be very sweet on your face, but they would be somewhere who would harm you in the end. So Felon's Claw is a very specific stroke observed in handwriting of dishonest people. It is usually referred to as a warning flag. I really take it as a warning flag. Graphologists claim to have observed Felon's Claw in the handwritings of majority of dishonest and criminal people. So while analyzing, we must ensure that we are not missing such strokes. Felon's Claw is a backward hook-like stroke found usually in the lower zone letters. Lower zone letters are, okay. So, just maybe, you know, your lower parts hain. These are your lower zone letters. So lower zone letters like J, Y, etc. It can also be found in other letters like capital I. It can be here in this form also, and like this also, like this also. Okay, so basically it's a claw, pakda hua hai. Next slide, Kainat. Okay, now connected writings. Connected writings and disconnected writings. Connected writings, what is connected writing? What is connected? Connected is a connection of thought process. Connection of one thought process giving rise to another and you're moving in the same direction. So people who connect their letters, alphabets have logical approach to everyday affairs. They tend to evaluate and calculate everything before taking any decision. Connection in handwriting is suggestive of fluid, logical and systematic progression of connecting ideas. Ek thought process ne dusre ko rise diya, dusre ne teesre ko diya, teesre ne chauthe ko diya. Isi tarah aapka idea jo hai wo generate hota hai. Since their logic is about cause and effect, their thinking is constructive type rather than the creative type. Now, there is a, can we move to the next slide? Disconnected slide. Now, what is disconnected? So this is connected when you have joined the words. You know, where you have joined the words. Disconnected is where the words are not connected. Now, when the writer disconnects the letters instead of connecting them, it reveals his dependence on the inner voice. Means, aise logo ki intuition bahut achhi hoti hai, disconnected walo ki. So-called the sixth sense, intuitions come from inside within us as they give us sudden hitch and to take a decision. Those who are intuitive type do not apply much logic and reasoning for making quick decisions. Ab, sabse bada ye hai, कि क्या मैं डिसकनेक्टेड हैंडराइटिंग में लिखूं या कनेक्टेड हैंडराइटिंग में लिखूं, क्योंकि ये अगर मुझे सिक्स सेंस दे रहा है, लॉजिकल बना रहा है, तो वो कनेक्टिंग ऑफ आइडियाज भी तो दे रहा है. सो द आंसर इज दैट यू राइट 50% कनेक्टेड एंड 50% डिसकनेक्टेड, और यू नो यू राइट इन अ कॉम्बिनेशन. दैट इज द परफेक्ट राइटिंग बिकॉज इट विल गिव यू कनेक्शन ऑल्सो, लॉजिकल माइंड ऑल्सो, एंड इट विल गिव यू you know, sixth sense. It will give you sixth sense and it will give you more of a logical mind also. Now, people who have connected handwriting, it is for people who have connected handwriting, okay? So people who have connected handwriting, it is seen that such people tend to get better results than people who write in a disconnected handwriting. Aise log last minute ki padhai bhi karenge na, okay? So this is not for everybody ki bhaiya ma'am ne bola tha connected handwriting to kal last minute padhenge. So don't go by these words, okay? So the connected handwriting people definitely unka handwriting ki wajah se result better aata hai rather than disconnected. Kyunki aapna connecting of thought processes connected hai. To isme kya hota hai ki jab aapne jo padha hai, agar wo idea yahan par question ulta turn hokar aaya, to aapne connect ek thought process ne dusre ko rise kiya, dusre ne teesre ko kara, aapko answer yaad rehta hai. But disconnected mein aap khud hi disconnected ho with the thought process. Okay, so this you can take as a tip that you can go when you're writing for your exam, go for a connected handwriting and combination works very, very well. Next, this so now some tips for you. High T10, it is for dignity and pride. Nana has already spoken. T-bar. This will help you to raise your dignity and pride. Okay, I dot exact and well centered. So this is I and I dot exactly on the I step. Now with this, when you're writing and putting I dot exactly on the I step, mera attention detail work pe bahut zyada hai. You know, when you're writing fast or you're writing and you're just putting the dot exactly on the I dot, what is happening? You're paying attention to the details. It should not be like this. Nahi to wo future mein sochte rahoge. It should not be like this. Nahi to past mein sochte rahoge. It has to be on the I step. Now, there are a lot of people who write I dot like this. This. Okay. So, कहीं ना कहीं ये वो लोग होंगे जिनको individual mark बनाना है. But somewhere down the line, these people have a childish nature also. They do have a childish nature also. But if you look at me, look at this. What is this? Somewhere down the line, attention seek ho rahi hai na? Aap dhyan se dekh rahe ho. To kahin na kahin attention bhi to ja raha hai. So they are somewhere attention seekers also. Shape of G like letter 8. Shape of G like figure 8, person has good fluidity of thoughts and is generally a good speaker and a writer. Okay. For positive thinking and optimism, one can go or shall go for ascending handwriting. Now, please make sure that the handwriting has to be on an A4 sheet. Even as a graphologist, jab hamare paas do handwritings aati hai where, you know, the one is on the A4 sheet and one is on the ruled paper, we do not take the ruled paper sheet as the handwriting sample. Because ruled paper, agar aapko de diya gaya, to aapko hum margins nahi dekh payenge. We would not know whether your handwriting is ascending, stable, descending. We would not be able to tell. So A4 sheet, if you're writing and your handwriting goes like this, somewhere like, hi, my name is, you know, it is going upward. So what is it saying? Definitely such people are optimistic. They are moving ahead in life. People who write like, hi, my name is, what is it? Decreasing. You're just dipping down. You're going down. there can be, you know, maybe at that, agar you have a younger brother or sister, okay, and you have come from, let's say, Vaishno Devi. What has happened? You have, you know, it's been a tiring journey for you. And next day, your cousin's brother or cousin says, "Arey didi, please, bhaiya, kal project, please help kar do na." So obviously, your handwriting will go like this. That does not mean that you are in a depressive state. That means you are physically or mentally tired. But if it continues to be, you know, in this state, then it is the need of the hour. Then you need to check why the person is going so depressed. But if it is going ascending way, then definitely such people have more enthusiasm, more motivation to move ahead in life, and they're more optimist in life. So to avoid procrastination, again, I said, please complete your tea so that you are not stuck in the past. And keep your E's open. E's. Now, what is E open? This or this? Now, what is this? E is for ear, right? So, what is ear? E, ear. I am, people who have closed E, they are selective listener. Maine jo sunna hai, main wahi sunungi, uske baad main sunungi nahi. People who have open E, I am more, I will listen to other people. I will listen to what others are saying. And also, people who write E like this and people who write E like this, such people with a closed E, they have more, they are prone for more digesting problems. They are prone to digestive problems. But people who have E like this, who write E like this, it is said that their, you know, metabolism or their digestive is more better than these people. So keep your E's open. Open is in the sense this. I think there's some Pooja Shirali who wants to, who has raised. Okay. Can you see E like this? So this is a closed E and this is an open E. Can you see now?
Yeah, ma'am, that was visible, but I think she might have another question because she had her hand raised before we started with the E. So, okay. Organizers, if you can let Pooja unmute so she can.
Yes.
She might be having some technical issues, I guess. We'll get back to her later. It's okay. We can continue. Okay.
So that is for all for today, for, you know, in terms of graphology. And ma'am, what if we write in straight line on a blank paper? What does, I can see after what does. Can you, somebody read the question because I cannot see the whole thing.
It says, ma'am, what if we write in straight line on a blank paper? What does that mean? Like, I think she's talking about...
So that is also one thing, that people who write straight, they are more balanced people. But, a big but. Now, I am putting lot of pressure to write straight. What am I doing? Putting lot of pressure so that I write in a balanced way. I am trying to show that I am balanced where I am not. So somewhere down the line in graphology, there is one rule which says anything extra is opposite to what the person is saying. Like, I am putting efforts to write in a straight line. I'm putting pressure, high pressure to write it straight. So that means I'm trying to show that I am balanced where I am not a balanced person. I have a fear of losing balance. But if a person's handwriting is, now what am I trying to show? Wow, broad, bada. Such people, you know, from their heart or from their, somewhere, they have a fear of something in their life, of losing something. This is actually, agar aap, what do you say, when you're going somewhere and there is a hoarding or, you know, which is thoda bada bada likha hua, you get attention. Your attention goes towards that thing. So it is basically attention seeking trait. Okay. Next.
A question in the chat box.
Right side. T.
Yeah.
Future. I'm always thinking about future. अरे यार कल शाम की पार्टी में क्या करना है, कौन सी ड्रेस पहननी है. I'm always thinking about future. I'm not in my present. Yes.
And the only. What if F is written without loop? More like the F we see in the, you know, in the typing वाला जो F रहता है, straight line there.
If I'm not wrong, you're talking about like this.
I think so, yeah. Because that is how the typed version. So yeah.
So somewhere down the line, you definitely have planning and execution. You definitely have, but for organization, if you ask me, which is the best one? So definitely, this is best. So I would prefer this. Okay.
Next. Ma'am, I have a question.
Yeah.
So about the letter E, I cannot keep the E open. I don't know. It kind of, I feel like it's, you know, incomplete. So what about that?
So I did mention, are you sensitive towards listening to other people? Like you don't just, you tend to miss certain things, and then if somebody is telling you something and you jump to something else, like, you know, you are a selective listener.
Actually, I don't think that I'm a selective, like I'm a good listener, I guess. Like I don't talk much, but I'm a listener.
You are a listener. Then there must be some other traits which we need to see, but it has been seen that people who write E, see, closed E or you are writing, for that I need to look at your handwriting. But if it is open, this is also open. This is also open. But this is not open.
I write like the first one.
So that is open.
Okay.
So you opened it. Aap sun rahe ho.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Next.
You have any other questions, you can either raise your hands or you can type it in the chat box and we'll be sure to answer that. So till then, I just have a question for you. What sparked your interest in graphology?
I was always, you know, interested in the subject psychology. I don't know, since my graduation days, I was very, very much interested in psychology. And I always believed that, you know, there is something else that, there is something which is very, very important to know about a person. And I was looking for answer. And what I understood was, I have done a lot of modalities, but what I have understood is that the subconscious mind is the most powerful thing in the universe. So it is only the subconscious mind that is important. And through your subconscious mind, you can come to know so much about a person. Even when I say that I'm a clinical hypnotherapist, that being a clinical hypnotherapist, also we work on the subconscious mind of the person. So everything depends on the subconscious mind. So your subconscious mind is the storehouse of all the information, actually. So whatever you are writing is coming from the subconscious mind.
Correct. So has your study in graphology changed your perspective or the notions that you formerly held?
Yes, my handwriting first and foremost changed. Secondly, I did learn graphology from a lot of teachers. So by every teacher who taught me, I think I was a better version of what I was before the workshop or before the, workshop that I took. So definitely I would say that every teacher brought a new aspect or a new knowledge for me. And yes, graphology has definitely changed my outlook towards people. Now when somebody, who's extra sweet to me or somebody who's sweet on my face, I don't go on their face value. I definitely go by what is written, because definitely it is said that pen is the tongue of the subconscious mind. And with this, I would just like to share one experience also. So there was one, I had just learned graphology, and then there was some person who came to our house, and he just, rang the bell and said, ki ma'am, main ye is pata nahi kaun si is jagah se hoon, and aapka shayad gas ka kuch hai, something he said. And I said, acha, theek hai, aap meko sign karke paper pe de dijiye, and aap meko paper de dijiye. And he was actually wanted to come inside, because he said ki main, I don't know, Indian se aaya hoon ya kahan se aaya hoon. So when I looked at the handwriting, the signature had the felon's claw. So when I saw this, I said, you just stand there only. And when I actually searched for him, when I inquired, he was not from that organization.
Wow. Oh my God.
So my outlook has definitely changed now.
Correct.
How can we learn graphology? This is for Mithi Bhai College students, all who are over here, that you can definitely join join me, because I am after discount for next 24 hours. This is for all, Mithi Bhai students, that every level I am charging 5,000 rupees and 5,000 per level. And this is after discount. So if you do the three levels, if you're paying for the three levels, that is if after discount, it's 15,000. I'm giving you additional 10%. For this is for people who are enrolling for next 2 days. But if you are enrolling for one, that is just, for the level one, then it is 5,000 per level.
Okay. Ma'am, we have another question in the chat box. Which letters can we get an idea whether the person is short-tempered or calm person?
Okay, so there is lot many traits for that. We cannot determine whether, with this particular thing we can come to know. But there is one very interesting thing, that is, you'll say that ye to letter T ke piche hi padi hui hai. Now, what is this? Is it coming like a weapon to you? What is happening? Stroke. It is, I would say, yahan se mota aur yahan aate aate patla ho gaya. Chubi ki tarah. So what is happening is, my anger is going towards the other person. Now, if it is like this, or like this, I would say, what is happening? It's going towards me. So I am somewhere agitated with my own self, frustrated with my own self. See, honesty, dishonesty, we have already shared with Felon's Claw, that you can come to know from Felon's Claw whether the person is dishonest or honest. Now, if you said about whether a person is honest or not, let me give you one example. And this is quite interesting. I'll give you two examples so you can come to know about how the subconscious mind works. Okay. You are my. So don't, if you're not, if you can't see the screen, if you can't see the words, it's okay, because just see the logic. You are my love, your name is sweet to my lips. Now, this sentence that says is, you are my love, your name is sweet to my lips. Okay? Now here, if you look the word love, it's what? Enlarged. Right? Now, name. What is it? Thoda bada hai, in comparison to other words. So love is also bada. Name is also bada. So that means if I say, let's take somebody's name, Raghav. Okay. If I'm in love with Raghav. Now, if even if a child is going in whose name is Raghav, to mere face pe kya aayega? Smile aayegi. So name, heart bada ho gaya. Right? But agar main yahan par, नेम ऐसे छोटू सा लिख दूं और यहां मैंने लव बड़ा रखा है सो देयर इज अ पॉसिबिलिटी दैट दिस पर्सन इज लाइक सो अगर किसी की लेटर में ये चीज आ गई सो देयर इज अ टेंडेंसी दैट दिस पर्सन इज लाइक बिकॉज द हार्ट बीट हैज एक्चुअली वो नहीं बड़ा हुआ हार्ट बीट से वो नेम जो है वो बड़ा नहीं हुआ है राइट वन इज दिस सेकेंड There are two people. One's name is Akshay, who says, my age is 18 years. Okay, this is Akshay, who has written. Second person's name is Raghav, who has written, my age is 18 years. Now, this person has thought for a while, and then he wrote 18 years. This person is just writing in the flow. So there is possibility that this person is lying. Okay.
I think Anahata has a question.
Okay. Ma'am, about the letter F. I write F in, I don't know, that subconsciously happens, but I write the letter F in three different ways.
That's okay. That's normal. That's definitely normal because you are writing because of your own experiences. Ho sakta hai. Up 0 to 7, 7 to 14. Okay. I'm taking somebody else example. Like, just let me tell you that 0 to 7, 7 to 14 mein, agar mere mother ne mujhe organizational skills bahut achhe se sikhai hai. Beta, bed ko achhe se tie karo. You know, kitchen mein cheezon ko achhe se rakho. Mujhe wo experiences diye hai ki meri organizational skills enhanced rahi hai. तो हो सकता है सबकॉन्शियस में मेरी वो चीजें रही होंगी अगर मुझे वो चीजें नहीं सिखाई गई हैं तो हो सकता है कि मेरी प्लानिंग और एग्जीक्यूशन इज नॉट इन अ यू नो इज मे बी इन अ वेरी डिफरेंट वे सो इट्स एब्सोल्युटली नॉर्मल योर हैंड राइटिंग कैन वेरी फ्रॉम वन यू नो एट एवरी टाइम बिकॉज आपका 70% ऑफ योर हैंड राइटिंग रिमेन्स यू नो सेम इट इज जस्ट समटाइम्स दैट योर हैंड राइटिंग वेरीज एंड दैट इज बिकॉज you know, some traits are your fixed traits and some traits are your unfixed traits. So fixed traits ye hai ki even if the age of 40, tum aap apni first standard ki notebook uthakar bhi bologe, oh, this is my handwriting. Why? Because there are fixed traits. Your IQ, even if you are in graduation right now, your IQ, if it's somewhere around 105, it will not happen that at the age of 40, it will come to 60 or 70. 105 se wo 106 ho jayega, 107 ho jayega, 110 ho jayega. But variation se 105 se 60 nahi hoga. Ya aap God gifted 105 se 140 above nahi ho jaoge. Gifted children mein nahi aa jaoge. Right? So there are chances that your F's can vary, but again, aapke total page par kitne F zyada prominent hai, wo farak padta hai.
Okay, correct. And what if your handwriting is not much, just slightly tilted towards the right? Slightly.
Tilted towards?
Right.
Optimistic. You move ahead with an optimistic state of mind.
Okay, thank you.
And that's nice.
Another question by Pooja is, can non-Metabi people join? I'm guessing she's talking about your program.
Right now or the workshop? Yes, they can join.
Okay. And I don't know how to pronounce your name, I'm really sorry, but many times, but not every time, I often write O which is not closed.
So I need to see the O, which O, but still, I'll give you a picture. This kind is again, if it is little open, if it is little open, then मैं थोड़ी बहुत secret share कर देती हूँ. But ये वाली तो अरे मेरे पेट में दर्द हो रही है, जल्दी बताओ, बता दो breakfast में क्या खाया था. So it depends on कितना variation में आपका O खुला हुआ है.
Correct. Yeah. And what does closed O with single not suggest about the person?
Depends on which side. You know, it depends that I can have to look at the handwriting. But a single loop is somewhere is this. The person can keep secrets. Can't bandi na pet ke upar.
Okay, and we'll take two last questions.
So that is cheaters for you, that felon's claw.
And Vidhi asks, ma'am, what if our handwriting is straight and a little large? What does that say about us?
Large and?
Straight. I think
straight and large. Now, straight is either the pressure. We have to look at the pressure. So without seeing, I cannot say. But if the pressure is normal and you are writing, you know, in a normal pressure, then somewhere you are balanced. But large, so you don't pay attention to details because jitna chota likhoge, aap detail work pe jaate ho. Aur ye wo log honge jo thoda sa large mein likhte hain. Chapter aaya, you go by the you know, heading. Beech mein nahi padha, fir aage padha, fir padha. Arey yaar, story pata chal jaye, baaki main likh lunga. Theek hai? So they have a more tendency to do such work. Yeah.
Okay. Just one last question from my side itself. So our theme for this year for Shitij is Sapno Ka Safar. So how would you describe your Sapno Ka Safar, and what according to you is the importance of dreaming big?
What according to me is dreaming big? Not, I would say not stopping. Why I said not stopping? Because obviously when you move ahead in life, you will fall. There is definitely you will fall. But agar aap gire aur gir ke uthe, to aap obviously aage bhi badhoge. So whether you dream small, whether you dream big, does not matter. The only thing is whenever you fall down, pick yourself up. Because if you pick yourself up, then only you will move ahead in life. So dream big, dream small, dream whatever, dream unimaginating things also, but never stop. And there is no age to learn anything. I feel that even if you are at the age of 40, 50, still if you have a learning spirit, sky is the limit for you.
That's really, really inspirational. That's amazing. So since we're ending, I would just like to thank our title sponsor, Mods and Soulzest, for this amazing, amazing
thank
workshop.
You.
Guys, if you are uploading a story of this amazing workshop, be sure to tag Mithi by Kshitij and Soulzest. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you so much. It was fun being over here, and thank you. It was just amazing feeling to be among youngsters and, you know, giving them or sharing my part of knowledge of graphology with everyone. So thank you. Thank you so much.
Great. I'm sure our viewers are thoroughly intrigued and fascinated, and I know most of them want to explore more of graphology. Yes. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you. Take care. Bye.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye. Bye.